Greetings of the day, students. So, in this lecture, we are going to discuss a subject called Production and Operational Management, which is a professional elective for your sixth semester. This is Salman, Assistant Professor of Mechanical Engineering, ISL College of Engineering. In this lecture, we are going to discuss a new subject, that is Production and Operational Management. In this lecture, we will be seeing the introduction part and we will try to start the session with the starting of the syllabus. So, production and operational management. So, this is a professional elective provided for you. So, in this subject, first of all, you have to identify, or first of all, you have to study about the what is a production, what are the operational management which you generally see in any of the industry, and what are the various types of inputs, how the production system is being carried out, what are the various types of production systems, how the plant layout is. Plant layout is nothing but your shop floor. You are having some production plant where you are going to convert the input or output. So how the plant layout should be there present, at which location you should be selecting. For example, if you see that sugarcane or sugar production industries, sugar mills generally need lot of water, so they will be producing the industries near the seashore. So every plant has some requirement. So what will be the ideal location for construction of a plant, how the layout, how the machines has to be arranged, what are the various factors. So that we are going to see in your first unit. In second unit, we will be discussing the work study or method study, that is nothing but how the work has to be carried out, what are the various techniques which we generally do, why, how, when we are doing some certain amount of work within an industry. For example, a labor is doing, performing a task, either it is on a task, lathe machine, drilling machine or milling machine. So what methods he is generally using, how his motions are being done, how he is going to lift the object, how he is carrying the object. So every motion has to be studied. Okay, so in that we will see about time study and motion study, both you have to study. Next is work measurement. This work measurement is nothing but how much amount of work he has completed in a particular time. So that standardization we will be seeing on what are the procedures, how we are going to see for work sampling. Work sampling is nothing but if he has performed 10 jobs, out of the 10 jobs, if you want to sample, you cannot sample all the 10 jobs. So randomly we will select any one or two jobs and we will see how the procedure goes. Next is forecasting. Forecasting is nothing but how the future demand will be there for this product. For example, if you launch a new iPhone or a new mobile phone in a market, so they will forecast how the future of this product will be there in, after 2 years, 3 years, so 10 years. So basing on that only, they will be try to produce the products. So that there are few calculations in the forecasting technique. One is market survey technique, Delphi technique, in quantitative method that we have moving average method, weighted average method, simple exponential, trend adjusted method. So this is one of the gunshot questions from your third unit, either it is a simple exponential method or a least square method will be continuously asked, and a 2 marks question will be like forecasting errors. What are the errors generally we do in forecasting? For example, I have forecasted that after 2 years, this mobile will be, it requires 1,000 pieces of mobiles. But whereas, because of the, like if you have forecasted that you might have completed the degree by the month of May, but because of lockdown, there has some errors. Similarly, in forecasting also, there will be some errors happens. So what are the various types of errors generally happens? Those things we will see in this. In the fourth unit, plans like aggregate production planning. So aggregate planning is nothing but if you are buying a material, if you are converting a, how the material has to be procured from the company, and how the that part has to be completed into that material has to be completed into product, how much amount of product is required at what time. So that planning will be there. That is nothing but aggregate planning, which is a part of master scheduling. That master scheduling will be this will give the input to the material, that is nothing but material requirement planning. Another one, we have manufacturing resource planning. We have two MRPs here. One you can see here, MRP1, another we will be having MRP2. MRP1 is nothing but material requirement planning, whereas MRP2 is nothing but manufacturing resource planning. For manufacturing, what are the various resources? Like for manufacturing, you need a machine, you need a labor, you need various types of tools, you need various types of holding devices. So all these things are called as your manufacturing resource planning. Similarly, when you are trying to this whole things to be centralized by using a computer, that is nothing but called as entrepreneur resource planning. So this resource planning generally in previously we used to do by using some different techniques. Now the because of the upgradation of the computers, we have evolved a new software packages like SAP, BAN. So SAP is nothing but a technique by using which the SAP is a software by using which we are trying to incorporate all the things into resources, like for example marketing, sales, your production, your rejections, your customer services. For example, you can take Amazon is if you see a portal, they will be having all the details from the production part till the delivery, and from again customer services to everything. So these all are controlled by using a few softwares. Those softwares are SAP and BAN. So these are the latest technologies in especially in manufacturing plannings. Okay, so next unit is project management. How we are going to control this project management? What is PERT? What is CPM? How we are going to schedule the your production? If there is any delay in the production, how we are going to overcome these? Okay, so those things we will be seeing in this unit 5. So the best book for this we say is Paneer Selvam. We have operational research, or we can directly obtain a production operational management by Paneer Selvam also. So Paneer Selvam is one of the referred book for this. So introduction to this is the production and operational management is a process which combines and transforms the various resources. So what are the various resources, like men, machine, material, are used and to transfer the material into a production and operation substitutions or substrates of an organization which gives the value. For example, you are having a plate, or for example you are having a mobile phone. Before it is a mobile phone, it is just a plastic material which has given added a value to the material. If you are adding some amount of thing, for example, if you take the basic mobiles and now touch screen mobiles, so by adding the touch screen, what is happening to the mobile phone? Its value is going to be increases. So any operation you do on a product, it will create a addition of value to that product. Okay, so that value added product or services in a controlled manner. For example, you are going to a restaurant. For example, if it is a local restaurant, there will be no proper water facility. You have to wash the water in a sink, you have to wash the water in a drainage. So but whereas if you go for a five-star hotel, what they will do, they will bring a finger bowl after the completion of your lunch. So these things will add the value to the task. Similarly, so why I am giving the example of service is nothing but both production and service, manufacturing and services, both are given to the customer satisfaction. If customer is satisfied, the value will be added. Okay, the set of interrelated management activities. What are the interrelated management activities? All the things which the management does for completion of production in a certain product, that is called as management activities, like planning of parts, planning of machines, ordering of inputs, that is nothing but your material order. Those all things will include as activities in a manufacturing. If the same management activities has been added to service industry, then it is called as operation. Now what is this service industry? Is nothing but customer service. Once your mobile you have bought, they will be giving you a 1 year warranty where the customer can raise the complaints. If the customer is not satisfied, he can return the product within 1 year or 1 month, one week. So these services they are providing to satisfy the customer. So these various services management which we are doing in an industry are called as operational management. So how the historic evolution of production and operational management happens is nothing but in the 18th century, Adam Smith recognized that economic benefits of specialization of the labor. So specialization of labor is nothing but previously the labor used to work continuously. He does not know what is his specialization. If you teach him to do a work, he will be able to do. He cannot able to identify how the subtask or how the things has to be specialized by him to perform the task in a good manner. So that has to be done by giving a skill to that, so that we can able to obtain him high skill and efficient labor. Okay, so in next in so these are all your management studies you might be studying in your MBAs, subjects. So next is F.W. Tyler. He implemented the Smith theory and developed the scientific management, where he has given few rights to the labor. So where the labor can be able to understand how to motivate the labor so that we can able to obtain the results from him. So for example, if you are having a labor in your industry, you should be giving him annual increments, annual bonuses, so that he will feel that the organization is taking care of him, so that he can give the organization more amount of work, he can give a full-fledged work. If you are not doing this thing, he will try to escape from your work. So how that, if you see the chronology of the various operational management techniques, so in the 1776 the specialization of the labors is given. Specialization of labors is nothing but basing on the interest, the labor will be sent either to a lathe machine, either to a drilling machine. Basing on his specialization, the labor will be sent to a manufacturing to the industry. Next is interchangeable parts. Interchangeable parts is nothing but we can able to make the parts, we might have studied this in metrology and instrumentation, where the different parts which can be changed again in various companies. For example, the Bajaj part can be used to other company. That interchangeability can be done, and how cost accounting can be reduced by using this interchangeability that has been evolved in 1799. In 1832, division of labor by skill, again the same thing, specializing him, again division of labor, assigning the jobs basing on the skill, basics for the time study. Next, scientific management time study, that has been given by F.W. Tyler, that we have seen earlier. Motion study, that is Gilbert. So what are the different type of motions which has to be done while doing or performing a task. Next, scheduling the techniques for the employees. Okay, so in this way, the next thing is 1927, human relationships, that is about how the senior and junior should be there, how the relationship should be maintained with them, how we have to give the instruction. Everyone should not come and give the instruction to the labor. So that human relationships has been established by Elton Mayo. He has given a contribution to that. So next is statistical inferences applied to the product. Next, sampling devices, how we are going to sample for the product for the quality purpose. And with respect to operational research application in the World War II, so the it has how the services has to be provided for the customer, that has been evolved after World War II. Digital computers, digital, just a second, I will try to charge my. So sorry for the inconvenience. So these are the various contributions, how the research has been carried out in production and operational management. Now in 1980s, you might be seeing that quality and productive applications, like what we said, just in time has been come, or TPS has been come, that is Toyota Production System, which has been developed in Japan, especially in Toyota companies. That was first identified by Toyota company. So just in time, these are the few concepts which has been evolved with respect to time in production. Okay, so what is the concept of production? Is nothing but it is a step by step procedure. If you take a material which has to be made into some part, so it will undergo a sequence of operations, either first it is lathe or drilling or milling or anything. So it will undergo a series of operations where the part will obtain some of complete features of the product which a customer is requiring. So thus production is a step by step conversion of a form of material, either it is a chemical or mechanical process. Why we say chemical process is nothing but, for example, if you see the heat treatmenting of material, those happenings in a chemical nature. Okay, so chemical and mechanical process to create or enhance the utility of the product for the use of customer. The production is a value addition process. At each stage of the processing, it will give some add value to the customer. So define the production as this scientist defines the production as a process by which goods and services are created. Here goods and services both will be coming, where goods are nothing but the final product, services are nothing but like your hospital services, your customer services, or your hotel services, like this. Okay, next is what are the various types of input? Generally we see in production is nothing but 5 M's, we call them 5 M's. One is material, machine, men. Information is nothing but material, men, machine, capital, you can write it as money. Okay, so material, men, machine, methods. Information is nothing but methods, and capital means money. So these 5 M's will give you the production always. These are the 5 inputs. Please remember these 5 M's. This will be again and again used: material, men, machine, money, and methods. So information is nothing but methods here. Capital means money. So these are transformed into a part by undergoing various types of steps. That is, first we design the product, we then plan the product plan. What are the steps the product has to be flowed? Then next, how the production, extra production, how the failures of the production has to be controlled, how the maintenance has to be done. So after that, the services will be coming. Okay, so either it is a output, that is nothing but product will be coming out as a output, or a services will be coming output. So during this continuously we need some inventory. Inventory is nothing but the stock which is present in your industry, whereas quality of the products, cost involved in it. The production system of an organization is that which produces the products of an organization. It is the activity whereas the resources flowing within the defined system are combined and transformed into a controlled manner to add the values of the customer, the values to the product. The production system has the following characteristics. That is nothing but production is an organized activity. Everything which you do in a production or services is an organized activity. When you go to some hotel, you first sit on a table, first they will give you some water, then they will take the order from you, then again the order will be coming after that. So systematically everything happens in an organized way. The system transfers the various inputs into the output. Various inputs like men input, material input, machine input, everything will be given to get the outputs. It does not operate in an isolation from the other organizations. Means separately we cannot do, everything will be incorporated to one another. There existing a feedback system about the activities. Each and every activity will be having a feedback. So when we say production systems, the production system basing upon the varieties of products, it has been classified into 4 types. One is job shop production, one is batch production, another is mass production, another is continuous production. So let us try to see what is the main difference between all these 4 techniques, that is job shop production, batch production, mass production, and continuous production. If you see job shop production is nothing but for a particular job. For example, if I say if a handicapped person or a physically challenged person comes to a showroom, he wants a car. For example, if he is a dwarf is nothing but who is having a short height, he wants to get a car. So he will have some extra fittings to that so that he can easily reach to the brake, easily reach to the clutch, easily have the access to the steering. So these are done for a particular specific customer. That type of things are called as job shop production. When I say job shop production, if you see in the graph, we can see that it is done for a varieties. Large number of varieties can be produced in this. So why a large number of varieties? Because the quantity, if you see, if I project this, the quantity is less here, the number of items are less, but whereas varieties are more, because one customer will not be same as a different customer. For example, I am going to a showroom, I am buying a scooty or a two-wheeler, I will have a different type of accessories will be buying. Another customer comes and he will be having a different type of accessories. So for person to person it will change. So job shop production is a type of production in which it is completely based upon customer. So for that customer, the varieties are different. Each and every customer will be having different varieties. But the amount or the quantity of production that is done basing upon the customer's requirement is either it is a 1 unit or 2 units or 2 units. He will not buy whole shop. He will be buying only a particular machine, one machine itself. But whereas batch production means every time if you see, there will be a series or a particular batch of production is done. For example, if I say iPhone 6s, till last year iPhone 6s was in a production. Now if you go and ask for iPhone 6s, it is out of stock. Why? Means the production batch has been stopped there. Now they have come to production of iPhone 11, iPhone 12, iPhone 12 mini. So the production has changed to other batch. Now they can go back, they cannot go back to the batch, previous batch production. So in particular number from 100 to more than 100, the job shop production will be there. But whereas in this 0 to 100 or 0 to 10 will be like this. So but whereas in mass production is nothing but it is a large amount, like thousands of parts will be generated. Parts will be generated for a particular thing. For example, two wheelers, thousands of parts will be generated. whereas similarly for if you see the varieties, so in this the varieties will be less, but whereas in batch production there will be few particular varieties. I have given example of iPhone 6s. That batch is produced for 1 lakh parts or 2 lakh parts. After that there will not be large amount or more volume of products, but the varieties will be different. iPhone 6, iPhone 6s, iPhone 6 plus, iPhone 12, 12 plus, like that. So the variety will be not as much as the job shop production, but there will be some amount of more amount of varieties will be there, but whereas medium amount of production will be there. In mass production, what will be there is nothing but it will be continuously produced in a huge quantity, but whereas the variety will not be there. Okay, for example, you take syringe injections. So if you take injections will be like 1 mm, 2 mm, 5 mm. So these are what do we say, mass production, they will be produced in lakhs of numbers, but basing upon the type of operation. Previously what they have done in mass production in of injections, they used to have a glass injections. Now if you say they are disposable, once you have used, they will be not used again and again. That is mass production, less variety but large number. Next is continuous production. Continuous production is nothing but which will never stop, it will be continuously produced. Example, needle. So needle, if you change the injection, the needle is however required for you. So the continuous production, there will be no varieties of product, it will be always the same product, but it will be generated for thousands of lakhs of volume. So the volume will be more number of items, less variety, medium number of volume, medium number of variety, noticeable varieties of product, less number of volume, very few products but large varieties of product. Okay, so the job shop production are characterized by manufacturing of one or few, only one or few. Here we say 0 to 10 I have given. Quantities are produced, designed and produced as per the specifications of customer. So what are the characteristics is nothing but while we are going for job shop production, the labor should be very much skilled. Why means the customer may give different orders, the operator who's performing those operations should be much skilled, so that he can take up the unique challenges, new challenges, and create large amount of varieties. High varieties and low volume products are generated, used for general purpose machines and facilities. Large inventory of materials is required. Why large materials? He can order anything, the customer can give you order of any part, so you should have all the materials and tools with you in your inventory. Detailed planning is required, whereas in job shop production, what is the advantages is nothing but customer will be 100% satisfied with this. So the because of general purpose machine facilities, varieties of products can be produced. The operator will become very much skilled when the different orders is given. Full potential of operators can be utilized. Opportunities exist for creative methods. The thing was, new ideas will be coming from this. Limitations is high cost. Obviously, when a customer gives a specific order for a special request for the vehicle, the cost will be obviously increasing. So inventory requirement will be more, which is again a huge storage for you, it will cost you more. Production planning is very much complicated. So whereas in batch shop production is nothing but American production inventory control of society gives a statement as a form of manufacturing in which a job possesses the true functional departments in lots, batches, and each lot may have different routings. So lots, I have said iPhone 6, 6 plus. So different lots, different types of routings. Routings is nothing but path through which the part has to be manufactured. It is characterized by a manufacturing of limited number of parts. So batch shop is, what are the characteristics if you see? This is a shorter production run. So it is run for a shorter period of time. For example, even in vehicles if you see FS, FZS, so different vehicles, Pulsar 150, Pulsar 200, 220, NS. So these are shorter period of time, one year, 2 year, 3 year, they will not be run on a continuous period of time. So when the plant and machinery are flexible to change, so when the plant and machinery setup is used for the production of items in a batch, and the change of setup is required every time when you change the batch. Okay, so when you are changing the batch, obviously different batches require different types of production, you have to change it. What are the advantages if you see? Better utilization of the plant and machineries will be there, promotes functional specializations, cost per unit is lower because you are producing large some particular 100 to 200 amounts, the cost of the atom items will be reduced. Obviously the job satisfaction will be there for the operator because he is continuously working on different type of parts. For every 6 months his work will be deferred. If you are continuously working on a same operation, you will get exhausted. So the what are the limitations? If you see, the material handling is complex because of irregular and longer flows. The production planning and control is complex in this. Higher cost is required when you do frequent changes and adjustments of the machine. Mass production is nothing but manufacture of discrete parts or assembly using a continuous process are called as mass production. Large number of production is done. If you see the standardization of product and process are sequence, I have given the example of injection. In this, the standard injection should be produced. You cannot use 1.5 mm syringe, 1 mm syringe. So it is a standardized, same type of part should be generated. Only variation is 1 mm, 5 mm, 3 mm. So this, in this way you have to differentiate. Beyond that, you cannot go for a large variety of things. So in this, more amount of parts will be produced, shorter time cycle is required, perfectly you have to balance the production line. So advantages, if you see, a high rate of production is done, so the cost of this will be very, very less. The labor which you are having need not to be as very much skilled because he is going to continuously doing same type of job. He need not to be getting skilled, he is not exposed to various types of customer needs. So he can perform the same amount of job anytime. Next is what are the limitations. If you see, breakdown of one machine will stop the whole process because this is depending upon a same type of machine. One machine is not doing any job means your whole operations will be stopped. Line layout need major changes. In this, the line layout is nothing but in this the operation will be undergoing in a same sequence 1 2 3 4. So you cannot go from 1 to 4 in this. Always the same sequence has to be gone. One machine down means other operations will be withheld. Next is continuous production. The continuous production facilities are arranged as per the sequence of production operation from the first operation to the finished product. Everything will be in a sequential way. What are the characteristics? The characteristics, if you see, dedicated plant and equipment with zero flexibility. Zero flexibility is nothing but you cannot change it. Flexibility is the thing where you can able to shift from one place to other place. But whereas in this, there is no possibility of flexibility. Material handling can be easily made fully automated because the material always flows in this direction only, in this line itself. Okay, planning and scheduling of the route will become very, very easy because it always goes in a particular same route direction, means it is easy to handle us. What are the advantages in this is automation can be done easily, standardization of the product or processes easily, the cost of the product will be very, very less because large amount of product is ready prepared. So the cost will be obviously reduced. Okay, so what are the limitation is nothing but flexibility cannot be done, very, very high investment for the setting up of a whole line. Product varieties are not there. Okay, next is product management. So the production management deals with the decision of making related to production process. When you are making the various production process, how the management has to be done, what is the management in production, what part has to be produced, where we have to produce, what time we have to produce, how much cost is produced. So the main object of the production management is this thing only: right quantity, right quality, right time, right manufacturing cost. The cost should be less because the customer is not ready to pay a large amount of cost. The time requirement for the customer is very, very less. The quantity is more quantity has to be produced. The quality of the product should be right so that the customer gets satisfied. Similarly, for operating systems, what is operating system? Any system which converts the input to provide the output which are required by the customer. It converts the physical resources into output, that is nothing but services. Waiter is coming to you, his physical resource, a waiter coming to you and asking the order. This is a service. So operating system is nothing but input from a person and doing services to you in terms of physical, okay, to provide some utility to the customer. Some of the examples is like hotels, hospitals, bus services, all these services which are generally given to the customer are nothing but operating services. So concept of operation. An operation is defined in terms of the mission it serves for the organization, technology. It employs the human and managerial processes it involves. so the distinguish between the manufacturing operation and service operations is that manufacturing operations are nothing but when you are doing service for manufacturing operation, a part has to be taken, physical need, a person is taking a part, going to the machine. So this is a tangible thing. Intangible is nothing but which cannot be seen. Service operations cannot be seen. I am giving service to you which cannot be seen. What I am doing behind, no one knows. Consumption of output, nature of work, degrees of customer contact, so customer participation and conversion. Next is measurement of performances. So manufacturing is characterized by tangible outputs, okay, which can be touched. Manufacturing services can be seen. If I am doing manufacturing service to you, I will give you a certain part or a product. For example, you are giving your laptop for service. So when you do service, you will be seeing the difference before use and after use. This is a manufacturing service, you can say. Okay. Similarly, you go to hospital, what he has done to your body, you don't know, but you feel good after certain period of time. That is intangible, which cannot be touched, but whereas this laptop can be touched. So that is touch can is nothing but tangible, in touch is nothing but intangible. Okay. So with this, we can able to stop. Next, we will discuss about the operational management. This is your first unit. This whole unit will be based upon your production and operational management itself, how the production is going to be carried out, how the operation management is going to be done. And next thing in this important is the plant layout, how the plant has to be designed, what is the ideal location for your plant. Everything has to be studied in this unit. Okay.